he's done a great job. I think everybody, when he first got here and got healthy and he got back running again, everybody saw his speed. And so for him to, you know, get a little bit of a roll, and he took advantage of it his first couple opportunities that he was out there. And then now he's found a nice role in our team and on our offense. And, you know, I think he's really made, you know, big strides with understanding of everything that we're doing, and we're allowing him and expecting him to do more.
Yeah, because I mean, it's not even just like speed stuff now. Like that third down play, we ran the little inside out route last week. It's just like a sign of you'll trust in him, right?
Yeah. No, there's definitely stuff where we try to get him the ball, and we put him as number one in progressions and things like that. And like I said, he's made the most of every opportunity that he's been presented with.
Any one of your just impressions of the Bucs defense? I know this will be with this offense first time you face the Bucs with this age. What were your initial impressions of?
Yeah, it's a good defense, and we've got players that have been in that system and have been playing at a high level. So I think for us, it's this team and the Saints organization and everybody, obviously they know them really well. And but their defense is playing really well right now.
I feel like we kind of phrase this question each week, just in the sense that, like, just how the season's gone, and it's your December, despite the record, you're still in the hunt, in a sense. And things can change if, you know, you beat the Bucs. Is that one of the things which is kind of crazy of how the season's gone, that you're still in it in December despite the record?
I think every team, if they could say they've got a shot to make the playoffs in December, they'll take it. Now, it may look a lot different than we thought it was going to, but at the end of the day, we are in the same position that a lot of teams are. And there's 5 games left. A lot to be decided in these next 5 games. And, I mean, that's all you can ask for. Obviously, you would love to have the record be different and all that kind of stuff, but you're in this position and we know what's in front of us, and now we got to make the most of it.
Have you ever been in this position? We're in December with this record still in it, though?
My year in Dallas, it was a down year for the NFC East, so similar position, yeah.
Is it kind of weird?
It is. Obviously, you would, like I was saying earlier, you'd love to have a better record and be and all that kind of stuff. But at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. You've seen teams that make it to the playoffs. I think even the year of Marshawn Lynch's big run, I think they were under 500, making the playoffs, won the division, and, you know, end up winning the playoff game and all that kind of stuff. So it doesn't really matter how you get there.
This game has been pretty intense over the years, a battle, you know, last time when they were here. How much bigger does it make it? How much more intense could it be because of the stakes with the NFC South?
Yeah, I mean, I think just a division game and the kind of the rivalry that's come from it. That's it. But you know, you don't make it bigger than what it is. It's already we already know the importance of this game.
Does a rematch game come across easier or harder since you already know the opponent?
Well, I mean, I think it's one of those things, especially when you're playing division games. You know the team really well, and so I don't know if it's, you know, easier or harder, but I think your familiarity with them plays a factor.
This might seem like kind of a dumb question, but like being in the position you're in right now with 5 games left, like is it like are these the situations where you really have to lock in, focus on one game, and not think about the fact that you're a game out, or, you know, that. Like, not think about the big picture, just focus on the...
Yeah, I mean, I think understanding the big picture is a good thing. Because, again, if you didn't focus on the big picture, then, you know, you wouldn't really know where you're at. And especially with the way the season has gone, and there's a lot of things that we wish we would have done better. You could be discouraged and all that kind of stuff, but... Or you can look at it as like, hey, we have 5 games left, and we are, you know, we're in this thing, and have an opportunity to make a run. And so I think understanding the big picture is a good thing. Obviously, you do have to take it one game at a time. You can't win 5 unless you win 1, you know, all that kind of stuff. But yeah, I think the understanding of the big picture is a good thing.
All good.
All right.
Thank you, Bo.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.